brain from where kids are bound to learn. Trent's about to lead out to a very special boy. Thomas just an average kid, family tits lore. Trent was at the junior hall when he was only 4. Tommy and Trent. Cool day. Cool day. Tommy Trent all day. Patrick used to go there, he did not have lots of fun. His old teacher Megan Cook was not so very nice. He got beat at tennis, his girls were screaming at his face. Patrick said no doubt and Trent was watching take his place. School days! Can you survive school day?
So, did you kids have a fun weekend or what?
Yep, we sure did, Uncle Jerry.
My favorite part was when we went to the mall.
The saddest part is when we have to leave. Why?
Don't worry, Alex. We'll see each other again on Wednesday. Goodbye, guys. See you in 3 days.
Come on, let's go inside.
Hey, kids. How was your weekend with Uncle Jerry and Michael?
Good.
Tom, Thomas, Tim Tommy, Tom is the tank engine, Tom is Marcus Connolly, Tom.
What?
I was just wondering why you're using the computer when it's not on.
I don't know actually.
Hey Tom, I'd like to give you something. You know how you lost your pencil on the bus last Friday?
Yeah. Why?
Well, here you go. Your brand new writing utensils. You've got a pencil, for writing obviously, an eraser just in case the one on the pencil wears out, and a pen for a backup writing utensil in case you lose or break the pencil.
Thanks, Aunt Sally.
Anyway, it's time to get ready for bed. Come on, Alex, let's get you to your room.
Okay. Good night, Tom.
Good night. I love you guys.
Get your ass off of my chest.
Hey, it's not my fault that kid can't display us properly.
Well then whose fault is it? Because it's definitely not mine.
Well, you're the one who decided to lay right next to me.
Would it kill you to lie down vertically like me and Patrick?
I can't. It's uncomfortable for us erasers. You should already know that, you fucking asshole.
Pinky.
Leadhead.
Both of you, knock it off. If we're gonna get through this year, then we've gotta work together.
Work together, with this pipsqueak? You can't be serious.
I may be small, but I can erase your words with just one swipe.
Why would I need you when I've got my eraser shoes?
Eraser shoes, only $2.99. Now.
Phil and Ernie, please stop fighting and focus. We're supposed to meet up with Professor Hummies tomorrow so we can begin our jobs as utensils.
You're right, we're sorry, Patrick. I don't know what came over us, but we promise we'll never fight again. Right, Ernie?
Yeah, we promise.
Good. Now let's get some shut-eye. We've got a big day tomorrow.
Tom, Alice, come down here. Are you packed for school?
Yep.
Did you pack the lunches I made for you?
Yes, Aunt Sally.
Good. Now head to the bus stop.
Okay. Goodbye, Aunt Sally.
Ah, such good kids.
Aunt Sally, can I go to the arcade with my friends?
Absolutely not. Just because you're homeschooled doesn't mean education is optional. Now get upstairs so I can teach you about the American Revolution.
Fudgesicles.
How could this happen to me? I made my mistakes, got nowhere to run. The night goes on as I'm fading away. I'm sick of this life, I just wanna scream. How could this happen to me?
Hey, what did I say about playing that song in the house?
I'm sorry, Aunt Sally.
God, where the hell is that stupid bus? Be patient, Trent. It will be here soon.
And by soon you mean now? Because it's coming this way.
Ugh, finally.
See, Trent, all you had to do was be patient.
Ha! So this is what a human classroom looks like. I never thought there would be paint, paper, and other art supplies everywhere.
That's probably because this is an art classroom.
That explains it.
Come on, guys, let's explore this joint.
Stop right there, mortals, for I am the almighty grabber, and I grab utensils that stand in my way. So if you want me to spare you, then I suggest you run back to your owner.
Jesus fucking Christ. Fucking run for your fucking lives.
Wait. Come back. I just want to be your friend.
Daniel, what are you doing?
Tom, are you aware that your utensils are alive?
Utensils can't have intelligent life, that's impossible.
Yeah, and Aunt Sally just bought them last night, so if they were alive, I'm pretty sure she would tell me.
But it's true. I saw your utensils walk, talk, and run away from me. I swear to God I'm not making this up.
Daniel, are you on drugs?
No.
If I can have everyone's attention, I'd like to go over today's plans. Today, you will be drawing two animals mixed together, kind of like a hybrid. I'd like them to be turned in by the end of class, and if you're not done by that time, it's homework. Begin.
What's homework?
Well, Trent, homework is a set of tasks assigned to students by their teachers to be completed outside the class. Common homework assignments may include a quantity or period of reading to be performed, writing or typing to be completed, math problems to be solved, material to be reviewed before a test, or other skills to be practiced. The effect of homework is debated. Generally speaking, homework does not improve academic performance among children and may improve academic skills among older students. It also creates stress for students and their parents and reduces the amount of time that students could spend outdoors, exercising, playing sports, working, sleeping, etc.
Jesus, I don't like the sound of that. And I think you wasted most of the class with that boring explanation. Quick everyone! Get some paper and pencils. We've got hybrids to make.
I'll show them all that those utensils are alive, or my name isn't Daniel Tony Leverage.
Okay, now he's just acting insane.
What was that, you bloody wankers?
Oh dear God, not again.
Daniel, get over here. We need your help.
I'm coming.
Wow, that was close. What the?
Waaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaa
Well, Tom, it sure is a good thing that we finished that highbrow drawing. I thought we were never gonna get it done. Now we don't have to worry about it for the rest of the day.
That's great, Trent.
Hello and welcome to my new and improved classroom.
I like what you've done with the place, Mr. Cannonberg.
Thanks, Daniel, you just made my day. Anyway, today, we're going to learn about George Washington.
Who's George Washington?
Well, Eddie, George Washington was an American statesman and soldier who served as the first president of the United States from 1789 to 1797, and was one of the founding fathers of the United States. He served as commander-in-chief of the Continental Army during the American Revolutionary War, and later presided over the 1787 convention that drafted the United States Constitution. He is popularly considered the driving force behind the nation's establishment and came to be known as the father of the country, both during his lifetime and to this day.
Oh my God, this is so boring. I can't listen to this for an hour.
I know. How do these kids do it?
Hold on, let me get that. Hello.
Hello, Patrick. I am Professor Hermes. One, see that you finally made it to the school district. Meet us at the tall wooden bookcase so we can get started.
Okay, see you there.
Who was that?
That was Professor Hermes. He wants us to meet him at the tall wooden bookshelf.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Wait a minute, How will our user be able to do any classwork without us?
Don't worry, I've got an idea.
Wow, just, wow. That'll fool him.
Well, if you have a better idea, I'm all ears.
Guys, we have a problem.
Oh, shit.
How the hell are we supposed to get across? Wah-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a-a- fucking realize you could have fucking killed me?
Well, at least I got you to the bookshelf, you ungrateful little shit.
So, Phil, do you think you can kick me over there as well? Nice work, Phil. But how are you gonna get over here?
I know. I'll jump across.
But you're a horrible jumper.
Don't remind me.
But can't you try?
You're right, Patrick. I can do this. I don't need criticism from a low-life pink midget.
Hey.
No, I just need confidence. Okay, here I go. No.
That's 2 weeks of detention for you, Eddie.
Man, that's bullshit. You must be fucking tripping, dog, 'cause I didn't do nothing.
Make that 4 weeks, and I'll call your parents so they can ground you for life.
Fuck you.
Sorry about that, Tom. Anyway, here's your homework for tonight. All you do is find the definition of these words in your textbook, and write them down on this piece of paper.
Fuck! Jeez, what's up with that guy?
Something tells me he's not a big homework fan.
Okay, we're at the bookshelf, so is something supposed to happen?
I dunno. Maybe those guys are running a little. What there? Where are we?
Hello, newbies, and welcome to the Utensil Laboratory. I'm Professor Hermes Stressman, and these are my assistants, Oswald Orangicus, and Jeff Yellowstone.
Oh, hello there, friends.
Sup?
It's a pleasure to meet you guys. I'm Patrick Penford, and that's my friend Ernie Aircross the Third.
Hello, listen, we had a pencil with us. His name is Phil Pencilton. We lost him on the way here.
Well, lucky for you, we're in the observation room. Here, we can observe the classroom you are in to make sure you are doing your job. Therefore, we will be able to find him easily.
He's dead.
Oswald, we don't even know what he looks like, so we can't assume he's dead without a physical description.
Oh yeah, I forgot or whatever. So tell me, what does this Phil character look like?
Well, Phil is a tall and slender number 2 pencil with pointy black hair. He wears a yellow duffel coat, green pants, and pink eraser shoes.
Eraser shoes, huh? I've heard of those. God, I would die for a pair of eraser shoes.
Oswald, focus.
Okay, okay. I found him.
Really? Where?
Here, let me show you. Oh, now, do you see the kid with brown hair in a red shirt?
Yeah, why?
Well, he's using your friend right now. How and let me tell you, I would hate to be him at this moment.
That's it. Wow. I will give you extra hope. Wow. 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 Wow.
So how do we save him?
Simple. We just wait here until class ends. We will know when, because at the end of class, the bell will ring.
I'm sorry, what?
Well, that was fast. Come on, let's go save your friend.
Ugh, the nerve at Mr. Cannonberg. I mean, who the fuck does he think he is to give us homework on the fourth day of school?
Trent, calm down. It's just a vocab packet. All we have to do is look in the glossary, and we'll be good. Besides, there's only like 5 words to define.
Whatever.
Hey Tom, did you notice that this place got redesigned? It looks pretty cool.
I didn't really look at it yet.
Well, you can look at it right now. You are in the room.
Good point. Wow, you're right, David. This place does look cool.
Why thank you, Tom.
No problem.
Anyway, today, we will be taking fill-in-the-blank notes on the planet Mercury, which I will hand out in a second. Okay, now that you have your notes, let's get started.
Unfortunately, the professor can't join us. He's busy recruiting other utensils, so Oswald and I will be your mentors for the year.
Great, so what do we do?
You and Ernie will stand around and guard Phil from distractions while he does the rest.
Speaking of Phil, where is he anyway?
Mercury is the smallest and innermost planet in the solar system.
Oh, there he is. Tom's using him to take notes.
Thanks, Captain Obvious.
Its orbital period around the Sun of 88 days is the shortest of all the planets in the solar system. It is named after the Roman deity Mercury, the messenger to the gods.
Tom, write that down.
Well, of course he's gonna write that down. What else would he do? Masturbate?
Like Venus, Mercury orbits the Sun within Earth's orbit as an inferior planet, so it can only be seen visually in the morning or the evening sky, and never exceeds 28 degrees away from the Sun.
Venus, inferior planet, got it.
Also, like Venus and the Moon, the planet displays the complete range of phases as it moves around its orbit relative to Earth. Seen from Earth, this cycle of phases reoccurs approximately every 116 days, the so-called synodic period.
You know, I just realized something. Whenever Phil writes, he looks like a black whiteboard marker. Why is that?
Oh, that's because GoAnimate doesn't have the writing animation for pencils, and the whiteboard marker animation is the best alternative our creator could come up with.
Well, if you ask me, I think he can do better.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
Jesus Christ, how long is this thing?
Well, usually one class takes either 1 hour or 45 minutes.
Thanks for letting me know. Wake me up when it's over.
Seriously, how did this kid graduate from the Eraser Academy?
Wow, you guys did a good job on your notes. My last class only filled in 6 blanks. For homework, I'd like you to write a 3 to 5 sentence reflection on what you learned about Mercury.
No, oh, 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 oh.
First Mr. Kemberg, now Mr. Lanzi. Jesus Christ, why is everyone giving us homework? I swear to God, if Ms. Enemer gives us homework, I will jump out of a freaking window.
You think homework sucks now? Just wait until you're in 8th grade. Things will get worse from there.
Those utensils are alive, and I'm gonna prove it. Ha 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 ha.
Proving utensils alive? What's that all about?
Apparently Daniel thinks my utensils secretly have intelligent life.
Jesus, am I the only sane person in this school?
We can discuss sanity later, Janet, because right now, we're gonna learn us some integers.
What are integers?
An integer is a whole number that can be positive, negative, or zero. Examples of integers are negative 5, 1, 5, 8, negative 2, and negative 10. Examples of numbers that are not integers are negative 1.43, 1 and 3 quarters, 3.14, 0.09, and 5643.1. Ms. Winters, can you please bring up the number line?
Sure thing, Ms. O'Namer.
This is a number line. The numbers on the right are positive numbers, which are the kind of numbers you are already familiar with. The numbers on the left are called negative numbers. Negative numbers have the subtraction sign next to them, so that's how you can tell them apart from positive numbers. Here's what you need to know about adding integers. If you add a positive number and a negative number together, you have to subtract. If you add two negatives together, you add. As for subtracting, here's what you must know. If both signs are positive, the answer will be positive. If both signs are negative, the answer will be negative. If the signs are different, Eddie, are you sleeping again? Wake up right now or you are in serious trouble.
Why, what? What were you saying again?
Oh, Eddie, how dare you fall asleep in my class and speak to me in an echo-like tone? That's it. Go to the principal's office right now.
Yeah.
Well, now we know who the troublemaker is.
Yep.
Now where was I? Oh yeah. If the signs are different, subtract the smaller absolute value from the larger absolute value.
Hey Tom, can I borrow your pencil?
Sure.
Oh crap.
Wow, is happening to me again, is daily of to rent makes me so sad, is keep me pants.
Wow, you guys did such a good job with your worksheets. You should be proud of yourselves. Oh, and since you're so good with integers, I'm gonna make you practice it for homework.
Did you hear that, Trent? We have homework.
Trent, what the hell were you thinking, jumping out of that window? Jesus, you could have been killed.
Look, I'm sorry. I was just frustrated about getting homework in every class.
Listen, Trent, homework may not be as exciting as a 3-month vacation at Disney World, but believe me, it does serve a purpose for us kids.
What do you mean, Daniel?
Well, Trent, it helps to prepare students for national and statewide exams and tests. It helps to reinforce what's being taught in the classroom. It enables parents to actively engage in their child's education. Plus, it helps teach fundamental skills such as time management, organization, task completion, as well as responsibility. What's more important is students get to demonstrate mastery of material without the assistance of a teacher.
Wow, that was beautiful.
You know, maybe I can give this homework thing a shot.
That's good to hear, Trent.
So what should we start with? Science, social studies, or math?
Doesn't matter. It's already done.
Hold on, what?
They're done. Every single one, even our Mercury reflection.
I don't understand. How is this even possible? Homework doesn't do itself, unless...
Good work, team. You should be proud of yourselves.
I don't care how you did it, I'm just glad it's done. Come on guys, let's go home.
Actually, only me and Daniel can go home. The doctor says you have to stay here overnight.
Fuck!
Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please comment, rate, and subscribe.
If you hated it, don't even bother commenting.
Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.
Who the hell are they talking to?
I don't know, just keep celebrating.